bullpen guys. Like, the Brewers are going to play matchup after matchup with all their litany of arms. My prediction, and nobody asked, I'm giving it anyway, Dodgers in seven, Clayton Kershaw, NLCS MVP. That's what I see coming.
I think one of the best stories that we haven't talked about is Yelich not getting the Triple Crown. What a tremendous story. I mean, just being so close.
He was right there.
And now to be able to have that ability in the playoffs, the biggest stage, not too many eyeballs on him in Milwaukee this season. Let's see if he can duplicate that performance.
Christian Yelich took the plate in game 162 with the ability, if he had hit a home run, I think it was the fourth inning, had been on first and second. If he had a home run
there, he
would have had it. That's how close you can come.
The reason why Nick followed up on that information, because he was shocked that I fooled that guy.
Man, I was very impressed.
He's out here watching MLB extra innings. Hey, Christian Yelich takes.
All right, guys. Time for an early in or out today. The Chiefs and Patriots have a big showdown on Sunday Night Football. We will get to see the best two tight ends face off in Gronk and Travis Kelce. This season, Kelce has more yards, catches, and touchdowns than Gronk so far. CC, you in or out on Travis Kelce being the best tight end this season?
Well, Jenna, I know how much you love it, so I got to tell you, relax on Travis Kelce.
Hey, America, I hate this.
Gronk has the crown. But, man, it might be transferring about mid-game. Definitely this season. Gronk, watching him, the toll is starting to, you can see that he's starting to lumber a little more early in the season. So I got my eye on Gronk. Kelce ultimately will be the best tight end potentially this season.
But right now, this moment, you're out. Right now, you
right now, he's got too many weapons around him. I'm Gronk at the best.
All right, I am in because up to this point in the season, Kelce's just been better. And where Gronk had really distinguished himself was his blocking. He's still that type of blocker.
Mm-hmm.
My friends at Pro Football Focus are friends, I should say Travis Kelce has been one of the best run-blocking tight ends in football this year. So when his receiving production is that much greater than Gronk so far, and he's not as much of a deficit on blocking,
yes,
thus far this year, it's been Travis Kelce. And moving forward, I have so many fewer health concerns with Kelce. Gronk's the most talented tight end I've ever seen. Right now, I think Kelce's the best.
Gronk's looking for another injury. Kelce looking for a date.
He's looking for another reality show.
Tonight on Fox, week six kicks off with the Eagles taking on the New York Giants. Vegas has Philly as 3-point favorites for tonight's NFC East matchup. CC, are you in or out on the Eagles beating the Giants tonight?
Jenny, you talked about it earlier. Man, all the home teams have won all the Thursday night games, and we believe the bus ride up the turnpike from Philly to Jersey, I believe the Eagles get it done. I'm in.
Basically, it's not a real road game.
No.
As far as travel.
Absolutely.
Man, I got a sneaky suspicion. I'm out on this. I think the Giants win. The Vegas line is tricky here. When the Eagles are only 3-point favorites, I feel like Vegas is begging you to bet the Eagles. Oh, how could you not take them? Giants are 1-4. You only got a late 3 points defending champs. It's a must-win game for the defending champs. When Vegas begs you to go one way, you go the other. I'm out. I think the Giants get a win.
Yeah, and Nick said the Giants are doing better at 1-4 because they scored 30 last week.
Yeah. I'm saying that they have a little,
with the yellow hair,
a little offensive momentum after last week. I stand by that.
His hair's going to get wet.
You're not going to bully me off that court.
Does he play football when his hair gets wet?
On to the NBA. Last night, the Lakers faced off against the Warriors. Brandon Ingram showed off the skills that made him the number 2 overall pick back in 2016. Dropped 26. Looked impressive against the Golden State Warriors. Nick, are you in or out on Ingram being a legit number 2 option for LeBron this season?
Up until last season, I would have been out on this. Because LeBron's number 2 options for the 7 years prior to that had been Dwayne Wade and then Kyrie Irving. But then last year, I saw it be Kevin Love, kind of. Jeff Green at the end of the Eastern Conference Finals. Like, who was Kyle Korver at the end of the regular season? Oh, I'm in. Brandon Ingram this year going to be better than Kevin Love was last year. And they won 50 games, got to the NBA Finals, so I'm in on that.
I'm in, too, because I also believe his skill set fits in with LeBron. LeBron's going to draw a lot of attention off of him. Man, this kid, too, is soft-spoken. He loves being a Laker. I'm just glad they didn't trade him. That's what I was worried about, trying to acquire another superstar. They're going to trade him. So I'm in with him being the number 2. Great example as far as who his number 2s have been with the Cavs and stuff of late, especially last season.
All right, finally, last year's MVP, James Harden, debuted a new move that had everyone asking if it was legal. their NBA says the move is allowed. CC, you in or out on Harden's move being legal?
I'm in. Man, the guy's invented. He's got like a copyright, patent on some of this stuff. He invented the... He's invented a couple of things. We got to give him credit for really highlighting, especially when defenders would put their arm out and him getting the reach through.
Yep.
You know, he's a creative basketball player. I don't think certain people don't even like watching him play. But I believe there's a creativeness to him, how he scores the basketball. I'm totally in because he didn't travel. Two steps and then a J.
I'm absolutely in. I'm very pleasantly surprised you're in as well. This is part of James Harden's brilliance. He's not a high flyer. He's not super fast. Mm-hmm. He's a little doughy. He's not a great athlete. And he's won a scoring title. He's won an MVP. Maybe should have won two MVPs because he figures out ways to exploit the rule book. It's like LeBron's crab dribble. You figure stuff out. Oh, this is allowed. People don't think it's allowed. Oh, it's allowed. I'm in.
If Larry Bird had come up with these basketball offensive innovations, he'd get a lot more credit. But he was that type of scorer, too. Harden, very, very creative. Doesn't get enough. He should get more support for the things how he developed his offensive game.
So just so I'm clear, it was a legal move?
It was. Stop saying illegal. It was legal. It was allowed.
Yeah, I'm saying it was a legal move,
yes,
not
right.
Illegal.
Just saying, yes. Legal. You don't have to say A in
legal.
Front of
it. It was legal.
It was
yes.
Legal
we'll
move?
You,
that's not
we'll see sentence. If we can get you a membership to the...
I don't need that.
There is no word club.
I'm good.
Stop with the word club. And Jenna wouldn't be let in.
Are you insane?
No, membership, man. You got to pay.
Are you... Okay, we're going to have
they
a
take your
process.
Money.
Got to take a break. Is Baker Mayfield ready to lead the Browns to the playoffs? That's next time.
I want to join a word
Jenna,
club.
Tell America to relax.
Jenna,
tell America to relax.
I can't say it and I can't take it.
Relax.
I hate it.
Relax.
Ugh.
There's certain guys we say in the locker room, they're going to ball today.